Welcome back in our ENV class. Now today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter 15, Fun with Clay. Okay, so in the starting of the chapter, one beautiful story is given to you. So let's see. Once there was a Kothimbu. Here we can see that it's a Kothimbu. Kothimbu means one type of fruit. Okay, it was running fence by fence. There came one crow. By seeing it, crow wanted to eat the Kothimbu. Here we can see that. Okay, crow wanted to eat the Kothimbu. And crow had opened its beak to eat Kothimbu. It said, who said that? Yes. Kothimbu said that, you cannot eat me by dirty beak. First, find some water and wash it. Who said that? Yes, Kothimbu said that, right? So crow went near the well to wash its beak and it said to the well, 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 oh well, here comes a crow, give me water to wash my beak so that I can eat Kothimbu and it's yummy, yummy, right? The well said that, if you want water, go to the potter and bring a pot and then fetch water. So crow flew away to the potter and said, potter, potter, oh potter, here comes a crow, give me a pot to fetch water, to wash my beak, to eat Kothimbu and it's yummy, yummy. Who said that? Yes, crow said that, right? So potter again said, bring some clay so that I can make a pot. So again, crow went to Timba. You know the meaning of Timba? Yes, Timba means heap of soil. Okay, again crow said that, Timba, Timba, oh Timba, here comes a crow, give me clay to give to the potter, to make a pot, to fetch water, to wash my beak, to eat Kothimbu and it's yummy, yummy. So Timba said that, take horn of a deer, who said no to you? Okay, so again crow flew away to deer and said, dear, dear, oh dear, here comes a crow, give me a horn to dig soil and to give to the potter. So to make a pot, to fetch water, to wash my beak and to eat Kothimbu. And it's yummy, yummy. So deer said that, you come to me and take my horn. Okay, so go and ask the dog, it will kill me. So again, crow went to dog and said, dog, dog, oh dog, here comes a crow to scare the deer so I can take its horn and dig soil to give to the potter. To make a pot, to fetch water, to wash my beak, to eat Kothimbu and it's yummy, yummy. Who said that? Yes, crow said that. Okay, so dog said that again. Oh bhai, I am too hungry. Drink milk of cow so that I can drink it and scare the deer. Again, the crow went to the cow and said, cow, cow, oh cow, here comes a crow, give me milk to give to the dog, to scare the deer, to get horn, to dig soil, to give to the potter, to make a pot, to fetch water, to wash my beak, to eat Kothimbu and it's yummy, yummy. So again cow said that, I am very hungry. Give me grass and feed me, then take my milk. Oh shit, then crow went to bring grass from field and said, field, field, oh field, here comes a crow, give me grasses to give to the cow, to fetch milk from it, to drink the dog, to scare the deer, then deer get horn, then dig soil, then to give to the potter, and potter make a pot and then fetch water and to wash my beak and to eat kothimbu and it's yummy yummy. Again, field said that, oh bhai, bring sickle from blacksmith and cut the grass. So again, crow went to blacksmith and said, blacksmith, blacksmith, oh blacksmith, here comes a crow, give me sickle to cut grass, to give to the cow, to fetch milk, to drink the dog, to scare the deer, to get horn, to dig soil, to give to the potter, to make a pot, to fetch water, to wash my beak, to eat kothimbu and it's yummy yummy. So blacksmith said that, take this sickle, right, your turn. So crow took a sickle and went to the field. It took some grass and fed the cow again, then took her milk and gave to the dog to drink. The dog ran to scare the deer, so it gave a horn. With that horn, the crow dug the soil and gave it to potter. Okay, so the potter make a pot. Then again, crow had fetched water and washed its beak and ate kothimbu. It's very beautiful story. Okay. So here we can see that the crow wanted to eat the kothimbu. So when the crow went to break and eat the kothimbu with his beak, so kothimbu said to him, first go and wash your dirty beak in the well. Right. So here we can see that crow roaming here and there. Crow meet some animals, birds and other rural craftsmen like blacksmith, then potter, some animals like dog, cow, deer. So the moral of the story, the fruit of the hard work is always sweet. Now here some more questions are given to you, see in your textbook. So first question is, why did the crow need a pot? So the crow wanted to eat the kothimbu, but its beak was dirty. So kothimbu said that, first go and wash dirty beak in the well. But well said that if he wanted water, get a pot from the potter. Okay, so that's why crow needed a pot. So you have to write in your textbook. Now second question is, who all helped the crow to make the pot? So the blacksmith, the timber and the potter helped the crow to make a pot. Okay. Now third question is, what things did the potter need? So the potter needed clay, water and a potter's wheel to make the pot. Okay. Now last one, are there utensils made of clay in your house? Which are these? So yes, utensils like a pot for storing water, a shallow pan for making rotlas, pots for plants, lamps, etc. made from clay are there in my house. You have to write in your textbook. Okay. Thank you, children.